Kiss FM. I am joined by Leanne and Perry of Little Mix.
Yay! Yay!
Ladies, it is just a joy to be here with you in real life, to be honest.
Oh, thanks.
How are you both?
Actually, quite well.
Yeah,
not too bad. How are you?
I'm fine. No, I'm actually really good. I'm a very, very happy girl. Yes. Congratulations on announcing your sixth studio album, Confetti.
Woo! Yay!
In this moment, I wish there was confetti just going off, but
I know.
We just didn't have the budget for it.
Party pop us would have done,
right? Yeah.
But it's all right if you still want to be cheap.
I'm so sorry for letting you down.
That's okay.
On that note, though, seriously, you've named your album Confetti. Surely legitimate to have confetti cannons in everyday life now, just at all times. Walking the dog, confetti cannon. You win an argument, confetti cannon. You walk into a room, confetti cannon. What do you think?
Can you imagine?
Can you imagine
every time
if you had an argument?
Oh, both.
Yeah. How funny. Imagine you're having an argument with your boyfriend and you win and you're like, from the sky drop like confetti.
You're welcome, though.
Yeah.
You can have that. Was that a little...
Thanks, I like it. Maybe it was.
Was that a little exclusive?
I'm the queen of leaking things.
Mate, I already leaked that yesterday.
Oh, the song?
That little line on my Instagram post.
Oh.
But then you did the tune as well, so you double leaked it.
That's what I mean. Oops, my bad. I didn't even realise I did it.
You do that. I love it.
I was like, woo, woo. Did that just happen? Well, thanks so much.
You're very welcome. Anything for you.
Yeah, I'm excited now. I'm so excited. How did you land on the title of Confetti?
It was easy, right?
Quick. Yeah, it just happened quick. I think. Here we go, Leanne.
Intruder.
No, there's a fly in the room.
Can't do.
It just happened, and I think as soon as we came up with the idea, we were like, yeah, let's run with it.
Yeah, the most instant album title on the album, and also
it's a celebration.
Exactly,
it's a party.
It does feel like a massive celebration.
We're having a rave up in here.
Yeah. One
quick question: you look absolutely stunning on the album cover, but I want to know how long you were finding bits and bobs of glitter on you after that shoot,
because honestly,
yeah,
I had it in my
everywhere.
Mouth. Did you have it in your mouth?
Yeah,
my tongue.
It was disgusting. I swallowed it.
I
probably had sparkly poop.
But if anything, that is very in line with your brand right now. So
it is.
You're living your best life, really.
It is. Yeah, it was fun though.
I want to know a little bit about how Little Mix goes down on a holiday. This is what I want to know. I want to know what a Little Mix holiday looks like. So I'm just going to ask you a few quick questions. Delve in, as they say. Perry, I noticed you've been on holiday recently, living your best life. Looks amazing. You're both kind of sunning yourselves, having your best time. And I'm really jealous, so I want to kind of get into that.
Okay.
Favourite childhood holiday memory?
Benidorm.
Tell me more.
That's all I ever went to. So we could afford.
I love Benidorm.
Benidorm was lit. The karaoke bars, bit of Why Not. Ugh, I don't know if that's still there. The Benidorm Palace with all the like dancers, the show.
This sounds
stuff
incredible.
Like that. Sat by the pool.
Did you used to get on the mic?
Oh, aye.
Karaoke.
I was so nervous when I was a kid. I was very like cling to my mom's leg kind of gal. And then as soon as I did one song, I'd be like, give me the book, let me give you a list.
Yeah, just shoving people off the stage.
Yeah, but no, my nana's like a goddess out there. She's very well known.
Really, what's her go-to song? Nancy's go-to song?
What does she, she sings all the classics. This is my life, and I don't give a damn about tomorrow.
Can she sing?
She's fantastic.
Really?
My nana is a goddess.
Oh, I thought you said your auntie.
No, my nana Nancy. Oh. Yeah, she's so good.
Nancy, potential fifth member of
Wow.
Little
Mix.
Do you know what? We don't want to be upstaged.
Oh, fair.
I'm going to say no.
Fair.
Yeah.
Perhaps she could support you on tour.
She could.
But you've got the search now to do that for you.
We do.
Yes.
That's very exciting. How are you feeling? Because it's been paused for a minute, but we're back in the game.
Yeah.
You excited for the start of the show?
It's going to be so good.
The talent on this show is so good. I think we were actually like shocked, weren't we?
Yeah.
Like, these people are coming for us on our show. Like, it's amazing.
Yeah, because we said at the beginning, we were like, the only way this show is going to be good. You're right there, hon.
Yeah, it's fine.
We said the only way the show's going to be good is if we have the talent. Like, if there isn't any talent, it's not going to be a very good talent show, is it?
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
But we had pinch me moments every time someone incredible came in.
But
we think, why are you not famous already?
I know. And each band is so unique and different. Mm. And I don't think a show has had anything like this before. Oh no, a show has never had anything like this before.
Never. I'm so excited. So yeah. And also it's the payoff of actually touring with you that I think is so wonderful.
Yeah, exactly.
We would have loved that as like a
right?
prize.
Right? At least just, there's a prize. Like there's never normally a, something like that.
The experience, like there's something that you can't get anywhere else.
Exactly.
Like when we toured with Ariana Grande, Demi Lovato, like all those people, it just elevates you a little bit more.
Yeah.
It makes you appreciate, oh, look at the size of this tour. Like, I want this for us, like for yourself.
And you're just giving back, girls. You're just giving back.
You
it's
know?
Absolutely lovely.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Back on these holiday questions. First holiday romance.
Well, not first, but...
oh, no, but oh, yeah, that's a really good
the
one.
The best holiday romance, oh. Yes.
So what went down?
So we were in a club in Marbella and I was looking over and we were all like me and my sister and everyone were like, oh, he's cute, what's that? And then
I'm like,
then I started dancing slightly in front.
Yes.
And then he grabbed my hand and then
oh, very forward.
Yeah,
very
right.
Confident.
Into it though.
Yeah, I think he'd had a couple drinks.
You must have been giving him the eyes.
Oh, of course I was. Yeah, I was on it. And then and then I said to him, oh, what do you do? And he was like, I'm a man of leisure. And I was like, what does that mean? Go away. And I was just, ugh, not interested.
The leisure industry, perhaps.
And then this other guy was just like, no, this is what he does. He plays for whatever, he's a footballer. And I was like, okay. But he didn't want to tell me he was a footballer because he was just like, it's kind of like a, he thought, oh, how can I explain it? Footballers have like bad reputations.
Oh.
And he didn't want me to know that, which is stupid.
It's fair enough.
And then.
Yeah, I kind of get
they
it.
They do have a rep.
Yeah, yeah. And then, I kid you not, from then it was the rest is history, really, yeah.
Oh, do you just love, love?
Oh, yes, so beautiful.
And then he got down on one knee.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, congratulations on
Thank
that as well.
You.
Smashing it, babe.
Yeah.
Absolutely smashing it.
Such a lovely couple.
That's a lovely holiday romance as well. I'm really heartwarmed by it.
Thank you.
That's lovely.
Now, we're going to go complete opposite. Embarrassing holiday stories, you know, flipping off the banana boat. All those types of things, falling over in the sand, tipping a daiquiri all over yourself.
Embarrassing holiday moments.
I don't know if I've got an embarrassing one, but banana boat does ring a bell.
I love banana
Worst experience of my life.
Basically,
really?
Just a constant wedgie for basically 10 minutes, and then you get dropped in the middle of the sea, and there's potentially sharks. It's
See,
horrible.
No, I was only a little girl when we went on one again in Benidorm. And the guy was like, I was literally terrified. I only went on there because my mum forced me. She has Debs.
Cute.
And got on there and he was like, if you're uncomfortable, just wave and we'll stop. And I was like, okay, so I'm there and I'm going, stop, stop. And he was like, and I thought, no, I'm gonna get off. So I got off and I had to sit on the boat and I don't know if it wasn't any better. It was so scary.
Do you know what? That sounds like my mum. She is the worst.
Like
so like-
Is she?
Oh, Perry. So, banana boat, she had to get off and go in the boat like you did.
What?
She fell off a camel in Egypt. Honestly, it was the most funniest thing ever, bless her. So she was on it, and the camel goes forward, doesn't it? And she went, oh, oh, and she just flipped over. She really did hurt herself though, bless her, but she's fine. Hilarious. And also, went quad biking, and she kept literally driving into ditches. So the little boy, bless him, had to drive and like drive her quad for her and she had to be on the back. It was just hilarious.
You really put your mum through it on holiday.
She's
like,
just, yeah. What? I don't know what's wrong with her.
Could
she's
Debbie.
Just, she's hilarious.
Queen of mishaps, Frail, Debbie. No. Queen of mishaps.
Where you get it from then?
Fragile. Yeah.
Just ditzy maybe.
Yeah.
Accident prone.
I don't know, yeah.
Listen, that's the best way to live, I think.
It is.
Has Little Mix ever missed a flight or nearly missed a flight? Like, you know, that panicky running through the airport?
Loads.
Has Little Mix missed? Yeah, wait.
Loads, surely.
Maybe when Paul was with us in America.
Yeah.
And out of all of you, out of all of you, who is the one that is most likely to miss the flight? Like, you're waiting always for that one.
Well, me probably because my passport is always missing.
Leanne forgets her passport every
all
time.
All the time.
That gives me severe anxiety.
Leave it in the safe, you know, when you leave it in the safe, you forget it's there, things like that.
Probably
Liability.
The first thing to check.
It is.
You think, right?
It is.
Just a suggestion for next time. No, yeah. No shade, like honestly.
No, honestly, it's
fine. It's the first thing to think of. It's very true.
I know.
I nearly missed a flight to Canada, but that's a whole other story.
Oh, no.
You want to hear it?
Yeah, please.
All right, so I was supposed to go to Canada, traveling around with my dad and his partner and my sister. And this was when I was single.
Single and ready to mingle.
Single and ready to mingle with a bottle of wine. Basically, I drank too much wine.
Oh,
and I was
no.
like singing. I remember singing karaoke in my bottle of wine in my cinema room, and then I fell asleep. When do you ever fall asleep without your phone nowadays? You just don't do. You always take your phone to bed.
Yeah.
I must have been that tiddly. I went to bed, didn't think anything of it. Someone's pounding on my door in the morning. I thought, who is this? I'm trying to sleep. Answer the door, and he was like, hi, taxi for Perry. I was like, you're at the wrong house. I didn't order a taxi. I was so mad. So I slammed the door, went back into the bed, fell asleep. Bang, 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 bang. I've been asked to come and wake you up. Is this blah, 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 where I used to live? And I was like, yes. And then I thought, oh my God, what have I done?
How could you forget?
Forgot. Ran into the sitting room, got my phone. I had like 40 missed calls from my dad, my sister, Joanne, like literally panicking. I had to just get in a taxi. I went in a bikini top. I was in that much of a pickle. I grabbed a massive, all I packed was a sheepskin cord because I thought it would be cold. Didn't have shoes, didn't have anything, didn't pack. Because I think we were busy at work at the time, so I thought I'll pack last minute. Got to the airport, had to take my massive jacket off, and my dad went, Joanne, she's wearing a bikini top through security. And I was like, Dad, I'm so sorry. It was actually one of the worst but funniest experiences of my life. Smashed my phone in the airport, screamed in the airport. Oh, it was the day from hell.
Oh my God.
So when I got there, I had to go shopping, I had to get a new phone, I had to do everything. It was an absolute nightmare. My dad was like, you are something else.
Congratulations, because that is probably the best almost missing a flight story I've ever heard.
I was wearing high heels. Why did I put high heels and a bikini top on? Why did I do that?
Right. I was thinking, like, I'm not a wine, hun. You can't, it's okay.
I must have still been drunk.
There's nothing worse than when you wake up and you're still drunk and that horrible feeling and you're late for something.
Yeah.
There is nothing worse.
And everything's a little bit slow motion. You're like, come on. Oh, yes. Bring it up. Yes. Quicker, Harry. Yeah. It was quicker.
Horrible. Oh. But I mean, we got there, we had the best trip ever, so.
It was all good.
Well, well done you for making the flight. Sorry, hun, but you did it.
Thank you. Do you know what I mean?
Smashed it, in my opinion. Final one for you, controversial, might split the pair of you up, I don't know. Is it legit to pee in the sea?
Yeah.
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
Absolutely, brilliant. No, I'm happy.
Although, you know when like you swim through the sea and there's warm bits?
Yeah.
And you get that bit
no.
But then do the whole eye contact with someone and be like,
oh God! Stop.
I mean, you definitely don't weigh in a pool, but you can weigh in the sea.
Yeah, or in the
bath. Not in the pool.
Don't weigh in the bath, the pool.
Ew!
But in the sea.
Who weighs in the bath?
Some people weigh in the bath.
Why would you pee in your bath?
Here's another one. Do you weigh in the shower?
That you're
bathing. I don't want to admit it.
I weigh in the shower.
I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
Yeah. I weigh in the shower and I brush my teeth in the shower. Not at the same time. Not at the same time. But those are things that do divide people.
If I'm in a hurry, I brush my teeth in the shower.
If you told Alex that you weigh in the shower, what would he do?
He wouldn't be bothered.
Okay.
He pees in the shower.
Well, I hope not, because he might see this and know.
What would you? Would he not like it if
he probably does. I'm going to ask.
Boys definitely weigh in the shower.
You think they do?
Of course they do.
100%.
Boys can weigh anywhere. They've got it good. It's convenient.
Yeah,
it's hard for girls.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. We need spaces to wee, and why not the shower? Kiss.